talking about for me?
I think the sense of any kind of punishment, it should be kind of like, in a sense, be the result of it. Because I don't feel like
yesterday's price is not today's price.
Buddha.
When I got messages saying, what's up with the show?
One, two, where you still got kids writing essays on.
472. Shout out to Chris, he came through.
Came back there. And you go, okay. And she said,
okay, he done. He gave me. It's not money, baby. They don't need cash in their hands.
Right. So now we're fuck with that.
Regardless of the back.
Welcome, welcome, welcome. This is the Smartest Dumb People, and I'm the host, Anthony, that dude, Johnson. And always, always, always to my left, Quando Rondo, my high school bud. We got a special guest in the building. He goes by the name of ILLCHILD. My guy, ILLCHILD, welcome to the show, bro. Man, one of the illest niggas alive. One of the illest niggas in Nebraska. Literally, when it comes to this rap shit, underrated MC, man. Listen, I told him, we was having a conversation before the show started. I told him that at one point in time, he put a song out, and I said to my cousin, I said, this nigga really about to make it. You know what I'm saying? So then we was talking about Peanut with this rap shit, man. We was chopping it up, man. What's the delay, bro? What's the delay? I like how you were saying, like, it's politics to the shit, and it ain't some shit you can just move how you want to move.
Yeah, I mean, for the most part, it's just one of the things where it's like, I'm not the person in position that has to put out 30 mixtapes or 30 albums to try to gain traction or gain attention. There's nothing wrong with that.
Yeah.
But it's just, I mean, it's like we built it up so high. I mean, we did billboards, performed at festivals with DJ Snake and Lupe Fiasco, cats like that, and we've done so many major shows. It's like, I'm just in a position where I can't backtrack. I can't do something.
You can't go backwards.
I can't just put something out just to put something out. So we just, honestly, just really just, and that's the politics of it. I'm just really tapping in, trying to, you know, reach out to my guys and put together a solid little budget so we can do it the right way. Instead of, you know what I'm saying, doing the label thing, doing our own label.
Oh, independent.
You know, I like what you said. You said it takes politics and money, and that's what motherfuckers don't understand. Like, you have to have a support system to get off the ground unless you got that drug money. And some other shit, but when it comes to just coming from the ground up, I'm talking about like some real shit. Even with us, it's a process. It ain't never been just, right. We just turned on the fucking camera and we pop it. No, it takes politics. It even takes money for views nowadays. So the doors are being shut and there's gatekeepers. And shout out to you made a phone call for me a little bit ago and I appreciate you for that. But I like how you were saying like it takes politics and money. And motherfuckers really don't use their resources. You know what I'm saying? Like, you are a resource to me. And I was like, one phone call, boom, he said, I'm coming. You know what I mean? But the problem is I always had this pride with myself to where I don't even use my resources. Me and you was just talking about it. We have to learn as black people, especially in the black community, to use our resources and realize, like you said, I've always been popping. Let's be honest, I've always been popular. I'm in a space to where I don't like niggas. Now, I don't mean niggas. I don't like people in general. Right. You know what I mean? So I just don't reach out to people. But like I said, one phone call, Nut was up here.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, oh, yeah, I'll be up there, bro. No problem. Whoopie whoop. I need to do better at using my resources, as do you. Because we just had this conversation. Because, nigga, me and LaRon always been popular. Always. Like, we always hooped. All three of us. You know what I mean? And motherfuckers don't know. This nigga was a beast on the court. Literally, that fucking ugly crossover.
That's where a lot of the popularity came from. But, like, in all actuality, like, you only as big as your network. So, especially doing what y'all doing, it's like, you gotta, you know what I'm saying, you gotta reach out to the people. Mind you, even me being in the position that I'm in, I guess people that look at me and think I got it already. They think I'm already on. That's ILLCHILD. That's Peanut. Or they don't want to, so they be like, he don't need no help. Let's go. Let me go put on my cousin
that been
rapping. Yeah, let me go put on this my cousin that been rapping in the basement instead of helping push him over the top, which is gonna allow everybody to get on. So it's like I be having to humble myself and reach out to people because it's like as a man I can't, you know what I'm saying, I can't put this down, I can't put the music down. Yeah, until I've exhausted all avenues. It's like I gotta try to do it the right way. And that's the only way I'll failed at what I'm doing. But I can't just sit back and not ask for help and then just be like, oh, y'all ain't trying to help. Y'all ain't trying to put me on. No, you got to ask for help. If people can't help you, they'll tell you they can't help you. Or they're going to give you an excuse. Well, either way, I did my part.
Yeah, all you can do we is don't ask.
But we don't, but we as a community, we as black men, we don't really, we're taught to not ask for help. And when you do, you're a bum.
Supposed to do it yourself.
Yeah.
But my thing is, if I do it myself, I'm going to have to do something I ain't supposed to be doing. Which will put myself in jeopardy of tricking off everything that I established, and then these same people that I could have asked for help are gonna come want to hang out with me.
Yeah.
Now instead of y'all sitting back watching me do the wrong thing, y'all can just help me. Y'all the same people that walk up to me every day like, you dope.
Man,
okay, bro, I need help. Look, help me. Man, the same way you got help.
Put the team together.
Yeah, that's it. Take a, like I just told you, it take a village. It don't take a lot of people. It just take the right people. If you really believe, that's like me being in the hood selling drugs. And my little homie in the hood, good at rapping. I'm not about to tell him to go get a pack.
Yeah.
Bro, keep rapping.
Preach that shit, man.
Keep rapping. And I'm good at hustling, you good at rapping. I'm gonna use this thing that I'm good at and help you put your rapping stuff on, and then we'll work it out from there. But I'm not about to tell you to put your life in danger.
Right.
Because you're better at rapping than me. I'm better at hustling than you. Everybody not meant to be a hustler, bro. Everybody not meant to work a 9-to-5. So it's like, that's it. I mean, well, that's kind of nutshell. Like, that's
the common ground is exactly what you said. Let's be honest, man. I'll speak on one person and one person specifically. My sister, she got a dope ass mind, and I literally started the woman's show specifically for my sister because she was so dope, right?
Yeah.
My sister got ahead of herself and started talking to me like I needed her, and I was trying to explain to her like I already have the platform.
Right.
You're just the motherfucker I'm trying to bring along on this journey because you're so dope. You know what I mean? And we all know motherfuckers that fell off the show and shit like that, but they have to understand that, like you said, there's people good at certain shit and there's people that's good at other shit. I was good at being the fucking engine behind the machine. I just want you motherfuckers to be the show. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm going to put everything together and we're going to make this a show. Like I said, even with people with LaRon, motherfuckers say, oh, I watch the show to see what LaRon going to wear next. Look what LaRon got on. He knows what he's doing.
Supply and demand.
Yeah, supply and demand. So what you said is 100% correct, Ron, when it comes to the community, bro. Why don't we, like he said, why don't we help each other and like be like, yo, you talented at this, man. Like I said, Bernard was Terrence Crawford for me before Terrence Crawford. The only difference is I don't know what push that Terrence Crawford had that Bernard didn't, but Bernard was very, very talented at boxing, which he's still dope now at boxing because he's like one of the best fucking people to watch on social media and shit like that. Shout out to you, motherfucker. You're supposed to been up here already. But we need people to have our back in a way, like Peanut said. If you're talented at something, man, let me take advantage of I know how to hustle. Yeah, I'm getting this money. Let me dump some money into you. That's what P did. Now look how rich P is about to be with QC off of just the little baby alone. He understood, like, no, little nigga, you can't be out here doing this, nigga. Be a rapper. We already know you know the streets. You a street nigga. But if you was a rapper and you was a street nigga, now he's the most popular fucking artist since Drake.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And P is the engine behind that machine, and you know P hustle. For a fact.
You gotta clean that money up.
Gotta clean it.
But at the same time, it's like even with the like movies. You see it in the movies all the time. When they, you know, the drug dealers, they tell the little basketball playing cat, hey man, stay in school, yeah. I got you. I'll buy your basketball shoes. I know your mom's struggling, dog. You know what I'm saying? I'll make sure you cool, just keep playing basketball. Like, that's, it's taking.
No, that's just the movies, though. That's not real life.
It's not real in our aspect.
Yeah, it didn't happen in several scenarios.
It's happened before, but I'm saying that has to be the mindset. Like I said, when they say take it really, like, that has to be the mindset. Like, you shouldn't want your people to put themselves in harm's way just to prove a point or to encourage them to take themselves
off. You have to have that much belief in a motherfucker, too. You have to have that much belief in a motherfucker, too.
It's like you really got to believe in it, though.
So, Nut, you know, like I said, first 15 minutes is always about you, bro. So, when can we expect an album, a song, something? Because, like I said, man, 4 years ago, I was like, he's about to fucking, like, just off of the song. And here we are. Talking about we need resources, we need to do this and that, and it starts in the community, man. Like I'm saying, that what is your next move from here on out?
I honestly have a full mixtape done. I got like 4 singles to go with the 7-8 songs that's on the mixtape. So I'm planning on releasing a song as soon as possible because I definitely want to get active during the spring, summer run.
Yeah.
I got a the tickets you got right here. I got a performance coming up at the Snowfall event with Rick Ross.
Oh, yeah.
April, what is it? 20, April 29th. So, again, I'm looking for that to be the springboard.
Yeah, open the door up right there.
Just for me to, you know what I'm saying? Like I said, it's been a while since I performed. That's going to be the first show I performed at in years. A lot of people have been asking for new music. I'm going to be performing all new songs at the show, the Rick Ross Snowfall event. And from there, I will probably set an actual deadline in regards to when I'm going to release the full project, but I'm going to definitely, I definitely want to try to release a song, have at least a song or two released before that event.
Speaking of that, make sure you like and share. Listen, for everybody in the chat, for the people that want to meet Rick Ross, and he will be at this event, I have free tickets to give away. I just want y'all today. I want y'all today. I want y'all to like, share, and I need you to share. When you share, I need you to tag at least 20 people. When you do that, you screenshot that to me, and we'll make some shit shake. So I need you to like, share, get the word out. Rick Ross is coming in town.
Tap in.
You know, he going to talk about his book. He going to talk about his merchandise. He going to be giving you game on what you need to do. We got these tickets, man. Make sure you like and share. There's 15 people in the chat. We need 15 likes. We need, but I need those 15 people to make sure that they go to the page, their own page, and tag a couple friends. Fuck it. We ain't got to say 20. Tag 10 friends and let me know. Holler at me. Screenshot it. I might have a ticket for you if you did it the right way. So it's time to start the show. It's time to start the show. All right, so let's get to it. First topic of the day, question of the day. Question of the day is biracial children black or white? A black, when a woman has a baby, a white woman has a baby, because this is tailored into Rachel Dolezal's conversation, but we want to get this out the way first.
Yeah,
so is a biracial child black or white?
Black. I mean, honestly, by society standards, I would say black.
Yeah.
I would say black.
Yeah. Skin tone matters more than people want to give it credit for.
As soon as they say biracial, you black.
Yeah.
And the thing is, motherfuckers do they motherfucking they do motherfucking shit to see what are you. You know what I'm saying? They do these motherfucking researches. They go back that far. And then that's what you are.
But see, my thing is this too. It's like, okay, do they consider, like, if a Chinese person had a baby with a Mexican, do they consider that biracial?
If the Chinese baby looked Chinese, it's Chinese. If the Chinese baby looked Mexican, it's Mexican.
That is only considered biracial when it's a black person born, right?
I think only white people have the culture to where they can be Russian. Like, all Caucasians have different nationalities within their nationality. So, like, a Russian and an Italian look the same. So they have to explain, like, I'm part Russian, I'm part... Like, no, when you look at me, I'm Zanika.
Yeah, but you can't... Yeah, period. For sure.
I mean, yeah.
But, yeah, it just depends on what you want to classify yourself as, basically. But if you do have black in you, you are basically black.
Yeah, because we are the dominant.
You can classify yourself what the fuck you want.
But I'm saying, like, I feel like that term biracial only comes into play when you got
Basically.
I feel like
biracial could be Mexican too, though.
That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, but they don't consider it biracial.
If a white person and a Mexican had a baby, they don't call that biracial. They either call them white or Mexican. They only call them biracial when it's black people. That's what I'm asking.
Yeah.
Or am I tripping?
No, that's not true. You're tripping.
Or am I tripping?
You're tripping. No, if I had a baby by a Mexican,
you're black.
That's what I'm saying. You're black though.
But I said if I had a baby by a Mexican,
you're saying you.
Can I get the motherfucking word out?
Are you saying the same thing?
But I'm saying, he said that biracial only come into play when it's black and white. Okay. No, biracial is any
race. But we're saying that as long as black is foundation. That's what he's saying.
But we're on two different things right now. I get what you're saying because you're right, but we're on two different things. I'm trying to answer what he said.
That's what he's saying.
I'm saying they only consider it biracial when somebody black is involved. That's what I was saying. Like, if a Mexican and a Chinese person have a baby,
that's a biracial baby.
Okay. In our terms.
Yeah, when they say what are you, they don't say I'm biracial.
I don't think
that's not a thing. Really.
I don't think they do that with any other race unless it's black involved.
All right, so is it time to tackle this topic? I feel like it's time to tackle this topic.
You got any biracial kids running around here?
Hey, so let's watch the clip. It's a documentary that hit the streets. Netflix dropped this documentary, and it's about this lady named Rachel. I'm going to say Rachel D is her name. This was a white woman that infiltrated the NAACP and became a higher up and ran a bunch of shit, but they didn't realize she was black. I mean, they didn't realize she was white. So when they found out she was white, all hell broke loose. Social media tore her ass up. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show a clip of the actual documentary, and I'm going to show you a clip of how she look and how she speaks and shit like that. Let's watch the clip. We'll be back with the conversation. Let's do it.
To really be black in America.
I even applied to jobs that didn't even require degrees, being a maid at a hotel.
Welcome to.
It's like that white black bitch that's in the news all the time. Rachel Dolezal. She always says that. She's a white woman, but then she dressed up like a nigga and shot her way up to the very top of blackness. And I always wanted to meet her just so I could understand. I just wanted to like have dinner with her so I could just look in her eyes and call her a nigger to her face. The fuck is that bitch talking about? I identify black. That is trans talk, lady. Stop biting. Stop biting.
This man right here is your father? Right there?
You have a question about that?
Yes, ma'am. Okay. I was wondering if your dad really is an African-American man.
That's a very... I don't know what you're implying.
Are you African-American?
That's Rachel D right there, man. She was a part of the NAACP, bro. And before we even go, I hope I can find her. I hope I can tag her. I hope I can find her. I want to say this from my heart and from the black community. I want to apologize because I realized that media had painted the wrong picture. And I want to break it down to everybody in the chat because I know everybody got something to say. When we first originally heard about this woman, all black people knew and all social media knew was it was a white woman that infiltrated the NAACP and she stole a job from it could be a black woman. Okay, but then I watched her credentials. She said Malcolm X is her hero. Listen, man, I'm the type of motherfucker that when it comes to certain situations, color does not matter to me. This woman was for the cause. And she was an advocate for the black community, and we failed her because we let white media tear her ass down, and we took the bait. And I'm telling you, anybody, I don't give a fuck. So what? She says she's black. There's men every day saying they women. There's bitches right now that swear down their guy. But when
she ain't black, though.
But it don't fucking, all right, so a man ain't a woman. Little Dwayne Wade ain't a woman. But okay, that's okay, right?
No,
by God way. By God way. Because let's be honest. We didn't do her ancestry.
No, I'm saying what's wrong with... Yeah, I don't know
we didn't do her ancestry.com.
I'm saying what's wrong with her saying that what she is what she is. She don't have to fucking claim.
I'm about to tell you why she did. Because she was dealing with the black community on a day-to-day basis. And shout out to Yo-Yo. She said it and I felt the same way Yo-Yo said, even though Yo-Yo didn't agree with it. Yo-Yo said she was advocating so hard for the black community and had nothing but black kids around her, black people. She just felt like she identifies black.
You ain't black.
I identify as a blood.
I ain't around
nothing but dogs.
Where's your blood?
That's different, though.
Yeah. No, it's not, Peanut.
It okay, is, so let me tell you
it
this.
Is.
What's wrong with the lady even doing all her social justice and all that and saying who the fuck she is? It ain't. Well, what's wrong with that?
Listen, not to cut you off, but the only issue I have with what she did was just saying that she was black. She didn't have to say she
was
black.
You don't have to say
you
black. You
can be for us, but you don't have to be us.
Like, right. All right, so what if she got, 25 niggas out of jail, saved 50 lives? That don't mean shit. All we care about at this point is that she said she
was
black.
No, I'm all for that, though. Yeah. And mind you, I wasn't one of the ones that tore her down for saying that she was black. I'm just saying that I'm pro her. Shorty was for the people.
Originally she just didn't want to identify as white.
That's just the weird part.
Remember the Chappelle show when they did the draft? We should have traded somebody for her.
I traded Jesse Smollett.
good point.
There's a couple black people we should have traded for her.
I want people to know her history because, like I said, a lot of people, and shout out to a couple of my ex colleagues, when they say shit like I don't do my research, they're right. Because in those moments to where I didn't know who she was and I watched what she did, I was mad at myself because now I'm doing the research on her, right? And I found out that she had three or four siblings that was black that her white parents adopted, but they were beating on them. So what she did was she adopted those siblings.
She probably said it when she had some black in her.
Yeah, once you go back, you ain't never going back. Everybody, look, I don't give a fuck. White women in chat.
I got a black in me.
White women in chat.
I got a little bit of black in me. Yeah. I got a little bit of black in me.
Got some bread.
And keep in mind, she had black children. So that's very important.
It is important, but it don't make you black. All you have to do is say the fuck what you want.
It doesn't matter
if she's black or not. That doesn't matter.
She could have said I'm pro-black, but you don't gotta say I'm black. I'm a black.
All right, so
I'm an African American.
All right, so again, this is what's wrong with. I don't know if it's social media. I don't know if it's the community.
There's nothing wrong with it. I'm just saying.
This woman was fighting for our rights.
Correct.
When does that matter?
It does matter. But guess what? The only reason. So be honest. Why did they tear her down?
Because they thought that she was only pretending to be a black woman for a job. And I'm trying to break it down to y'all. That was never the case. Again. It was never about the job. It was about this woman was an advocate for the black community.
How did she get the job?
Let's talk about that part. Why did she feel like she had to tell people she was black to do what she was doing?
She didn't go out of her way to tell people. Watch the documentary. She didn't go out of her way to tell people she was black. It was being addressed.
Okay, when a motherfucker address you, so why the fuck you say, nigga, I'm not black?
All right, so what if I hang around, all right, I'm going to give another
example.
What if I hang around nothing but Mexicans, right?
Right.
And I'm talking about my whole life.
I've been staying with Jose all this time.
And you know, like on Colors, when the black dude had the motherfucking pants all the way up his stomach and acting like a vatos, he thought he was Mexican.
He didn't think he was Mexican.
He thought he was a vato.
He was a nigga accepted in their hood. He was a nigga accepted
like
in their hood.
Like you said earlier, if I hang around all blood, I'm a blood probably. If I grew up around here, I'm around, but that don't make me him. All
right, so I got a better question. And when I speak on this, I want to be very sensitive with this because he was my dog when he was alive. But everybody remember White Boy.
Yeah.
Nobody can't tell me White Boy thought he was white. And God rest his soul. Nobody could tell me White Boy thought he was white.
But he ain't around black people.
There's a lot of people, but guess what? They know they're white. They don't say, I am black.
Was he really white? He was fully white, though?
I think he was fully white, bro. But I'm saying, like,
it's not even just him.
It's a lot of them in the community that be around us so much and so long.
But it doesn't matter. But guess what? If this is your time you own and you are helping the community, there's nothing wrong with saying, I'm not black. But
all right, so
I'll fuck with them.
Yeah.
And again, Yo-Yo said, she said, she should have never been the president of the NAACP. I get that. I expect it.
But she only got a job because she said she was black. But the shit she was doing was presidential Vice presidential shit.
All right, so let's see here. It says he's responding to
Carmelia Harris shit she was doing. For the
did she say she was black or did people just assume? And that's what I'm saying. Shout out to JR. No. People assumed for so long, and nobody questioned her in the black community, that this motherfucker, like, maybe I am black. And then, like, the white media came out with a white reporter asking her a white question because that's what they do. Man, listen, I'm gonna tell you the most dangerous motherfucker on the planet.
So she never came out and said I'm black.
The most dangerous, yeah, she did. On applications and some other shit. But the most dangerous motherfucker.
Time out.
The most dangerous motherfucker in our community is a white advocate. And they tore her ass down the minute they got a chance to. Because they didn't want her to be no white woman helping the black community. Well, y'all better wake the fuck
they
up.
They tore her down because they found a loophole. If she wasn't saying I'm black, they couldn't tear her down.
Right. That's about.
That's the only thing she fucked up about. Just saying she was black. If she just didn't say she was black and she just kept doing for us, she would be fine. She probably wouldn't have been the...
She might be going for the vice presidency.
We would have put her on. Now, mind you.
She would have been secretary.
But see, that's the thing,
Joe
too.
Joe Biden would have put her up in that motherfucker.
Why can we allow... All right, so time out. I'm glad you said Joe Biden because it just struck a chord with me. Why would we allow this old white racist motherfucker to say, if you don't vote for me, you ain't black. But we got a white woman that's in a position of power helping black people. What's the difference? Because I want to be black.
The difference is,
Joe Biden told us niggas. He said, if you don't vote for me, you ain't black. A racist white motherfucker.
You want the worst racist motherfucker out of there.
Man,
he was the biggest racist.
No, he wasn't.
Man, you sound stupid.
Man, first of all, listen, we need Trump back in office. Let's be honest.
I agree.
He was better than Joe Biden.
He was better than Obama. I don't want to talk about that either.
He wasn't better than Obama.
Hey.
You want to look at the stats?
No, I'm not worried about stats. I'm talking about the situation. Where motherfucker had the white versus the blacks. Period. Point blank.
I mean, again, he played the media thing. He used that to boost his stature. I get it. But at the same time, bro, he did more for us than most of these other presidents and everything.
All right, so did Rachel. So listen here, I gotta get some of these comments, bro, because these people are jumping. So let's see. He said, okay, so basically, it's a check on a box. You can't rise to the top of nothing just because of the check in the box. So basically, and I agree, but listen, we still gotta understand. There's still, what's the law? To where you gotta interview a certain amount of minorities. What is the law? It's the smartest dumb people.
The Rooney Rule in football.
No, it ain't the Rooney, no, it ain't the Rooney fucking rule.
It is in football.
Somebody said in the chat. I'm a little tipsy.
I don't know what it's called, but
I'm just trying to explain to people, like, we fail her, man. I don't give a fuck what y'all say. This woman can't get a job, and then there's black people in the chat talking about, I watched the documentary, and then she's like, how she can't get a job, and there's black people in the chat like, welcome to our world. You wanted to be black,
okay,
don't you?
So listen, this is my thing too. Like, okay, so she was advocating for the people.
Mm-hmm.
They put her in position with the NAACP. They started tearing her down in social media, so they just let her go? They just said, fuck what she doing?
People think she resigns. No job. I have never seen a human being actually resign.
Or she stepped down because the pressure got real.
No, she resigned because they said, bitch, we're going to fire you. So we're going to fire you polite. Resigning is being fired politely. I don't know if people realize that.
No, I get that. Yeah, so, why would they? I mean, if she was... For the people doing her job, why would they just cut her off just because they trying to tear her down for saying she black?
Look at this woman! She has box braids.
No, man, listen.
She has box braids, bro.
If I scroll through my Facebook, I can show you some more white women.
She has box braids, man. This woman was an advocate.
She's an advocate.
So why did they let her go?
All right, black community, because this is the black community right here. Black community. I got to ask y'all this question. What's more important, this woman pretending to be black or this woman helping our community?
Her helping us.
Okay.
They let her in because she was black. They didn't just let her in because she said she was black. They didn't just say, oh, you black, okay, let you in. That's my point. Put in work. Okay, so why did they let her go?
Because they politely fired her, which I said, resignation is the most politest firing.
The thing is, I'm saying, regardless of what the fuck you gonna do, why the fuck wouldn't you just say what the fuck you are? I'm a motherfucking white motherfucker, and I want to do this for you.
Facebook blocked the guy, a white guy, that said he identifies black, right?
What the fuck is he going for the community? I'm talking about this lady,
right? I feel like he was talking about white boy.
White Boy was in the community for real.
But his name is White Boy. Like, we knew what the fuck. He wasn't saying my name was. Don't call me White Boy. Call me Nigga Boy.
But I was just saying, like, in my eyes, he was black. In my eyes, he definitely felt like he was a nigga.
Yeah. I mean, shit. Yeah.
But I'm saying, like, so why does it matter if she's for the culture and she's. Her upbringing is for the culture.
It ain't. Why identify yourself as a woman
if you're really a man?
We rock with who rock with us. Like, you know,
I mean, that's what I said. Like, the world, you know why the world is attacking her or attacked her and still was keeping a foot on her neck? Because she was doing something for the black culture. And wake the fuck up, people.
Okay.
It's like having eyes wide shut. Yeah, we sit up here debating about this woman's nationality when she was literally doing the groundwork to support us. It's called, you had a whole album called Eyes Wide Shut, huh?
Yeah. But, like I said, my issue, she was for the people. I would never be against somebody that's for us.
Right.
Regardless of your skin tone, I think it's just, why would you lie about
JR said, everybody lies on their application. I agree. Yolanda said, I never have, and I show check the box white and show up to the interview. Shout out to Yo-Yo. She said that last night. She said, she said, you do it, your next job interview, you put on an application, you white, and then show up as Anthony.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I get that, man. But listen, but Anthony also ain't walking around with blonde wigs on, acting like a pal. Because it might work. I don't know. She was wearing box braids and, like,
painted her skin and all type of shit. That's weird.
She didn't paint her skin. She got a tan. Normal white people do.
Well,
paint.
He said painted her. She was not walking around with the blackface, bro. Yeah, she just got a tan. All right, let's new topic, man. I feel like we touched on this enough, and I'm gonna be honest with y'all. If y'all learn anything from this conversation, anybody that's in the chat, if y'all learn anything from this conversation, as black people, I'm talking about black people, and I'm talking to my advocates, my white advocates here, that woman did nothing wrong. Besides loud application.
That's it.
And we got our foot on her neck still to this day.
That's it. We as
in a culture.
We support her.
Who we? Meet Peanut and Laurent? Because they tear her ass up. They tear her ass. She can't get a job. Do you understand? White people turn their back on her. Because in y'all eyes, I just break it down before we get out of
this. So she still putting she black on her applications?
No, I doubt she is.
If she puts she white,
but listen, white people, y'all have to understand this. White people turn their back on her because she identifies, because she was helping the black community. And that's where we're lacking. Because the black people turn their back on her because she says she black. Bitch, you ain't black. But the white community, like, bitch, you was trying to help the niggas. Well, I don't fuck with you. So at this point, pick a side. I'm for her. I'm telling y'all.
She's going to get a job.
She needs to create a non-profit.
She can't get a job.
She needs to create a non-profit and keep being an advocate and doing what she's doing.
I'm going to find her, bro. I'm going to find her.
Yeah,
she could get a PPP. All that.
Yo-Yo. This is what me and Yo-Yo going to do. We're going to find her. Me and Yo-Yo going to find her and interview her. We're going to go down there. She's somewhere in like Nashville. We're going to go find her. I want to have an interview with her, and I want to sit down with her and Yo-Yo and have this conversation. Because like I said, this woman, she did a lot of shit for the culture.
She ain't did nothing wrong.
She better make a GoFundMe.
Besides saying I'm black. That's it. That's the only weird part of the game.
Let's see here. Somebody
this said, ain't black.
Carmen said she's checked mixed on a survey at a job. And had the option, and they said I had to pick one. All right, so that's what I'm saying, though. We are now choosing for these people instead of realizing the main common goal is.
Well, when they say you got to choose one,
they want to know.
You just said white, you get your foot all the way in there. White, just take it.
Do we got
to? You don't even give a fuck if you don't do what. I want this job. If I got to consider what the fuck I want, just click white.
We supposed to be setting up We supposed to be setting up a smartest dumb people trip. We need to go see Rachel, man. She's my new favorite. She's a hero.
So it's two applications get put in. Both qualify for the job.
Yeah.
One put black, one put white. Who going to get the job?
White.
Okay, so from now on.
Not in NAACP, though. They're not going to pick up.
Confused on what the NAACP is going to do, period, because why would you kick her out if she's for us? If she's doing her job good enough to be a vice president.
Because they had to clear their name up. They couldn't have that stain on their name that they let a white person infiltrate the fucking NAACP. You know how the president of the fucking NAACP
if he was going to get out, when he found out. Bitch, you gotta let you. I gotta sue you. Shit, I might not have to work again. Bitch, I'm gonna get a job.
She should sue the NAACP, low key.
What's she gonna sue him for?
For discrimination.
Big lawsuit.
All right, y'all. Let's get to the next topic, man. Next topic. We got... Where am I fucking... All right. So, next topic. Oh, this is a very sensitive subject, bro, before we watch this clip. I want to let everybody know this in the chat. Advisory. Because I debated on showing it. I reached out to one of my advisors. I debated on showing this clip because it's so violent or so fucked up. And I have no choice but to show it because... we are a media platform and we got to get the word out what's going on in society. So it's a 12-year-old girl. She was playing with a gun on Instagram. I did bleep out their faces, so you can't see that. And I did bleep out the actual shooting scene. But there's a 12-year-old girl. She wound up shooting her cousin in the head, her 14-year-old cousin, then turned around and tried to, she fell in shock. And then when she fell in shock, what her mom said was she tried to pick the gun up and wound up shooting herself and killing herself. So two teenagers, well, one about to be a teenager, wind up killing themselves playing with a gun on Instagram Live. So like I said, this is an advisory. I struggled with wanting to show this, but I feel like the people need to see it, so we're going to show it. This is the actual clip. So that's the actual clip, man. It's sad. It's very sad, RJ. JR, it was hard for me to share. Like I said, I had to reach out to my advisor and say, man, you think this is appropriate to show? Because, like, I want to show it, but I want to have a conversation. But I wanted y'all to have a visual of what happened. And I'm telling you, this is why, if you're a gun owner, shout out to my son, shout out to me. You have to lock your guns up because... In a situation like that, that 12-year-old girl just probably got her dad's gun. I don't know the details. I don't know why he had an extended goddamn, he had a whole drum on the motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? But right. At the end of the day, this child, and also, the goal is to make sure your children take safety classes for you just having a gun in your home. You know what I'm saying? Like, and I feel like we lack that. Like, I feel like we don't have no training behind it. So when your child is doing some weird shit, because, I mean, I probably would have at 12 years old, too, went and got my dad's gun, just, especially if there's a...
Right, you don't even know nothing in
there. Yeah, there's so many guns and stuff on TV, like, it's just kind of, yeah, if you got access to it, you probably would, like, pick it up and play with it.
Well, the thing about it is that, like I said, we got to do a better job as parents and make sure that our kids don't have that shit, you know what I mean, that shit available to them. And if you like, one of my
more accessible right now than any time in life.
One of my homeboy, one of my homeboys got a block of guns, but he got a thumbprint machine where only his thumbprint can be used from the opening, right, and it's by his bed. I think that's the smartest thing to do. Like, you should be able to access your guns. Your kids shouldn't be able to. If you have a gun, it shouldn't just be sitting under the goddamn bed. It shouldn't be just sitting under
the bed. Don't be able to have your shit locked up when you need it and you can't get your thumb on it. Well, when you need your thumb...
You must be speaking from experience.
No, I'm not speaking on experience. I'm just saying,
period. Like you said, when it's time to use it, you don't want to have to be able to...
Yeah, how the fuck you think you going to put a thumbprint on your shit when you need it?
And looking to open it to unlock it.
So, in the situation where a 12-year-old girl killed her 14-year-old...
I don't know how the fuck she got it.
The gun should be somewhere locked up. It should not. If the parents ain't home, the parents ain't around the gun, it should be somewhere locked up.
It should be accessible, or where they know where they can find a fucking gun.
No, not at all. That's not good.
That's the weird part. I don't. But
parents drop the ball on that.
I don't want to be having it with. I gotta.
It should be just like that, though. It should be you just put your thumb. He put his thumb on the thing and then it unlocks so he could start firing once he put his thumb.
Yeah. Well, there's actual guns now that where you can't even shoot without your the crease of your hand.
You know what? I think what it boils down to, I think you need to fucking teach your kids how to fucking handle the fucking gun.
No, that too. That's, if you got guns in your house, you should definitely teach them how to handle it. You shouldn't have it in your house if you're not gonna teach your kids how to handle it.
Don't fucking touch this, first of all. And if you do, this is the way this shit works. Because this motherfucker is going to blow your fucking whole head off.
That's what you say to your kid. This motherfucker going to blow your fucking head off.
No, but I will put it in layman's terms.
I feel like you just did when you said it would blow your motherfucking head off.
Sometimes you might have to talk to him like that.
Listen, got to.
They might not understand. They're like, don't do that or you're going to hurt yourself.
But that clip right there needs to be a safety video for children in schools or whatever. Like, because, nigga, that shit's sick. That shit,
and it can happen that fast.
She didn't understand how the trigger works. You know what I'm saying? Like, she was playing with it, shot her cousin, and then she was so shocked she fell to the ground and awed that she just fucking damn near blew his head off, and then tried to grab it and then shot herself. That shit's nuts, man, and this shit happens every day. We just don't see it. And now with all of these media platforms, only why that ever was shown and was public to the world is because it was Instagram Live and somebody screen recorded. I mean, it was sick and it was kind of ill that she went out like that and she killed her cousin like that, and it was not intentional. The mom already came out and said that from what they know, it was definitely them playing with the gun. And you can kind of tell in the video that they were just playing with the gun. It's just,
and thing is, kids, you have to give them motherfuckers, you have to put a fucking fear in their life. You can't just let these motherfuckers think it's fucking cool to have guns and play with guns. You know what I'm saying? It ain't cool to play with guns. So you gotta let them motherfuckers know, motherfucker, don't touch this motherfucker ever. This is not a toy.
But dude, that don't mean they're gonna listen though. We know kids.
Well, you never know if you put the right message out there.
Lock that room door. You should be in the room somewhere safe. Locked up as well.
All right, so we're going to jump topic. Last topic, man. Well, last topic we're going to touch on. We got 17 minutes left. A guy tests his friend. He pulls up on his friend. His friend pulls up on him. He said, I got $1,000 in my pocket. I'm going to drop it on the floor and see if my homeboy take it. See, and then I'm going to call him. He basically set his homeboy up to see if his homeboy would give him
a loyalty test, huh?
Loyalty test, which I don't think that shit should ever be a thing. Because you should just trust your friends. Like, I don't put my friends in odd situations.
Yeah, let's figure it out. Let me see the video.
Let's watch the video. It's a 2.5-minute video. We'll watch the clip with me.
Y'all, so I got this bread, right? About like a band or something. And what I'm about to do is I'm about to go into my guy car. I'm literally about to put this money in the seat. I'm going to potentially leave this money in the seat just to see if he's going to give it back or not. Or he was telling me I dropped it. I ain't going to say nothing. I'm literally just about to go and drop it. See what he say. Here you go. Yeah, he been giving me some weird vibes lately, and I don't know if I can trust him or not. I'm about to put him to the test right here. What's up, family?
What's good?
How you feeling, bro? What you up to?
Man, chilling.
What you on?
I'm about to get
a
little homegirls.
Oh, for real?
Little felines.
Oh, yeah, I can dig it. I can dig it. Yeah, so what you been up to, man?
Man, oh, shit, getting it, bro. Just working. You know what I'm saying? Staying busy, staying out of trouble.
Yeah, I called you over. I was going to ask you, bro, if you wanted to, if you knew anybody with any studio time. I know I could have texted you, but I just wanted to know if you knew anybody.
Clean the seat or on the side or anything.
In the car, in my car?
Yeah, on my seat, where I just got out.
Let's see. I don't see nothing on the seat. What you driving?
It wasn't nothing? No. Bro, pull back around. Pull back around real quick.
Pull back around?
Yeah. Look at this. I know he's seen it. It was right there on the seat. I literally got out on purpose. Boy, I tell you, I should knock him out. I should knock him out. Yeah. Yeah. There you go.
You know.
So this was literally all that was there.
That's all I seen. I wouldn't want you missing nothing. You know what I'm saying? You my boy. Oh, okay.
Yeah, yeah. You could make sure everything there, and then just.
Damn, to... man! I swear it was like 1,000. This was all that was there. So this 60?
Yeah, yeah. That was there. You said it was about 1,000? Nah, that was all that was there, bro. So yeah, go just take that and make sure you're good, bro. I wouldn't do you like that, but if I was grinding, bro, I took everything. You know.
You know what?
I'm a solid.
You know
dude.
What, fam? I'm just gonna leave this at that, bro.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I know. I did this on purpose, fam. I literally left the band in here on purpose, and this is fake money, by the way. You know what I'm saying? This is prop money. You know what I mean? You can keep that, fam. You know what I'm saying? You can keep that bread, bro. I don't even want it. Keep that bread, fam.
What you mean, fake?
That is fake, fam. That money you just took from me, and I know I dropped the band on the seat in fake cash. Yeah. Yeah, fam. I should knock you out, though. But I ain't even on that, bro. Yeah, it's fake, fam. But you can keep that. You know what I mean? You just showed me your true colors. You can keep that, fam. You know what I mean? Keep that fake money, because that's what you is. You is fake. I only want it, folks. Delete my number, fam. And I hope I don't ever see you again. And if I do, I'm knocking you. I'm knocking you out. No, I don't want that.
That's your phone. All right, so that's the actual video of the man basically leaving $1,000. This is homeboy trying to give him back $60 or some shit. I found $60.
You serious?
Man, yeah. But it was fake prop money anyway. So, do y'all think this is fair as a homie to even... I'm going to be honest with you and speak from my perspective. I think he's out of line to even put his homeboy in that situation.
Facts.
Like I know in your head you want to believe... this nigga won't do it. I get it, because this nigga shouldn't do it.
Nah.
I don't know.
And then it's like...
That ain't your real nigga then.
Like, that's like, not true. How close was they? Was the homie, the broke homie, was he going through something? Why you definitely can't
just put yourself in that situation.
Yeah, like, one, it's like, you know, if I'm up,
yeah,
those things don't even cross your mind, and it's like, especially with certain homies, like, of course I'm never gonna
see again. We live in a world to where niggas gonna cap to themselves and say, "I would never." A nigga got $1,000, like you said, it matters. I got $1,000. No,
how close are y'all? It's like,
how close are y'all?
I'm not about to test my real homies like that.
Yeah, I wouldn't even play those type of games.
Give it to me, like.
LeRon, like, even in situations where I'd be having to leave or whatever, LeRon would be like, "I'm about to pee real quick." And I'm like, "Nigga, I'm leaving. Bye. Stay here. Right. Stay here. I know everything in my place is going to be completely fine.
That's going to be for sure."
Yeah, but you yourself would say, "Nigga, wait for me." But I'm like, I don't want to wait for you because I trust you. And
you don't
like
that.
It's just principle. It ain't like
it's just. But I'm saying, like, to put him in, that's like me.
He ain't that close, evidently, to that
obviously
nigga.
Obviously not. If you're doing a loyalty test, the nigga ain't as close as that nigga.
I agree. Like, I don't even...
It's
like,
different shit. It's like a nigga that you met on the bar. That nigga from the hood. Oh, like, let me test that nigga. Hey. Oh, this nigga think I'm on the hood? Oh, this was like some hood test or something.
He could be somebody, like, he could have been the dude that you doing a loyalty test with, could have been on bullshit from jump.
Yeah, don't even fuck with you the long way.
I'm telling you he was loyal.
Yeah.
Man, I fuck with you, dog. I'm trying to get close on some BS, and then you did that, and it turned out to be true, but you're not going to do that to nobody you really cool with.
Yeah, I agree with you. Make sure you like and share. You want a ticket to the Rick Ross event? We have them right here, man. Make sure you like and share. I need you to like, share,
that's all you got to do.
10 people.
That's all they got to do.
Tag 10 people.
You're that's all they got to do.
You're going to get a ticket.
We'll get it.
$15 for free. You're going to get two. You're giving out two.
Tap in.
You want to take your boot thing or something to go meet Rick. And shout out to the young lady that hit me up and said that's amazing that you have Rick on your show, blah, blah, blah. Get these tickets.
I thought you was going to have somebody slap the motherfucker like Chris Rock or something to get the ticket.
We could do a slap fest.
Slap fest.
I'm just fucking with you.
Look, man.
Hey.
I feel like in that situation, let me get some of these comments before I go. Trust no one, Carmen said. And Musette said, you can tell how fake cash feels. A lot of these videos are staged. And skits. Like, I agree. It took everything in me to post it because I was like, this shit seemed fake. Just how he got in the car originally. What's up, G, bro? What you about to get? Like, why you getting in
the car? But he didn't have time to feel the cash. He took the knot. Shit, he ain't gonna look. Is this shit real? Nigga, I'm taking that nine to see what's good after that. Nigga, fuck that nigga. That's what he said.
That nigga said, I got $60. I found $60.
Yeah, I found
$60. Oh, JR said maybe he was going to make a big money move. And if you can't trust him with a few bucks, you can't trust him with big bucks. He was wrong for challenging that man like that, man, because you don't know what like. I like what you said, though. You don't know what a nigga going through. A nigga might be like, this is a blessing. The Lord left $1,000.
I don't give a fuck who you. That ain't your real nigga then.
At all.
I don't give a fuck what kind of blessing you thought you had. If you had your worst time, nigga, if you leave $1,000, nigga, it's going to be there.
Ron, you say that because you got a lot of solid niggas in your life, but niggas ain't solid.
At the same time, now, even on the flip side, the nigga that left $1,000 could have been the grimy nigga. He could have been the disloyal nigga.
Like, he was disloyal to me for even doing some weird shit. Like
he didn't even feel like that. Like I'm a check my.
I get what you saying because you're around a lot of solid niggas,
but guess what? Once he only said he only got $60, nigga, you should have beat his ass then. Nigga, this is all you got? You sure?
Put that on. Damn. You know what's funny?
Put that on. Somebody
a lot of people believe see. LaRon will punch the shit out of a nigga because of that, right? All times. That's just, when you be saying shit, I be like, this nigga really a dude.
You only got $60.
That's all you found, right?
That's
you're right.
You got $60. That's it.
Ask him three times to make sure it's
wasn't
correct.
More than that. That's right. All you found is $60. Put that on some.
That nigga LaRon will do that shit. He will punch the shit out of nigga. Like, that's all you found, $60. But also, in the same, like I said, you around a lot of solid niggas, which is a lot of people is your family. That's what you understand. Yeah. A lot of people is your family. So you don't really deal with the fuckery. But I've been around a lot of niggas, a lot of sneaky ass, weird ass niggas. And like I said, I done been through some shit to where I believe that can happen to anyone. I believe that in the grimiest moment, you can't, like you said, you don't know what a nigga going through. A nigga right really don't even have gas to get home. And he got $1,000 sitting in his seat.
He probably asked you for $1,000. Yeah. And you like, I don't got it.
Yeah.
And then he found $1,000. Like, nigga, damn, this is a blessing. Like, yeah. Nigga,
it's not personal.
I'm about to get you fixed. It's
not personal.
I just asked you for $1,000. I found $1,000.
Let's see here. Jamal said, I would have busted on a boy giving me $60 back rent.
Oh, I gotta pay my rent.
JR said, opportunity is Steve's best friend. I agree. He said, shout out to JR. He said, opportunity is Steve's best friend. I agree. Like putting a person in a vulnerable situation, you don't know how they're going to respond. So don't do it. That start there. And that's what the society we're living in, niggas is doing weird shit, putting money in the seat to see if they man gonna take it from them. Nigga, who does that? Who does that?
All right. It's a clout chasing society right now anyway for you to put it out there. So, yeah, you don't even have to fucking put it out there. If you're gonna do that fucking test, do it on your own time. You know what I'm saying?
If he rubbing you the wrong way, like, you shouldn't be
around him anyway. Don't know your two options. Nigga, you don't have to post it to make it. If this is what it is, this is what it's gonna be. Motherfucker, okay, you did that faulty ass shit, nigga, I ain't gonna fuck with you.
But I'm not gonna post you a world star.
That's all I'm saying.
And then make a mockery
that's
of
that.
Yeah, that's what
I'm saying. He really did the snake, nigga.
Yeah, like, this is really society right now, anyway.
Because that what he did, like you said, and it also depends on their relationship, because what he did to you, he might not do to his other homie that he loved.
He ain't gonna do it because that ain't in real niggas. Yeah. The other nigga might be real nigga.
I'm not questioning nobody I'm around. Like,
right.
Like, if I got a question, that's why I'll be by myself, bro. I ain't. Nothing personal to nobody else. It's just, nigga,
I don't hang with
but
people.
You gotta hang around a quality of niggas that you everybody.
Like you are. The type of nigga that you are, you need to hang around them type of niggas.
Yeah.
So if you a grimy nigga, you around grimy niggas doing that
rat
type of
niggas
goofy
hang around
shit.
Rat niggas.
Yeah, period. Yeah, that's fine.
Rat niggas hang around rat niggas, grimy niggas hang around grimy niggas.
You can't, like that song said, you can't be a pigeon and expect to soar with eagles.
Yeah,
I know. You're a pigeon.
But the eagle ain't gonna come test the pigeon either. So
no, that's why I say you can't hang around.
Hey guys,
handle your business.
He got now something it's to say. Time to say goodbye to all my Negro friends and Caucasians and Rachel D. I got a fetish for Rachel D. Now. I love her, man.
I think she's dope, bro.
I do. I think that we are failing her as a community because this woman was fighting for us, and it's weird energy that niggas is mad at her application.
With the spill out there, though. What? You're still warm.
Oh, because I want to get peanuts panhandles and stuff. I gotta like, oh, yeah, well this that whole shit right here, bro. This
no,
that,
you're talking about Rachel B.
Because I got a thing for her. So, Nut, what you got going on, man? Give me your panhandles, man. Your Instagrams, your Facebooks, your YouTubes.
All of them is the same except for my Snap. ILLCHILD402 on Instagram, Facebook, all that. My Snap is Illy402-5500. But, yeah, man, YouTube, you type in ILLCHILD, you don't need no spaces. New music coming soon. The Rick Ross Snowfall Affair, April 29th. Make sure y'all tap in with that. All new music. New music coming this summer.
The boy go hard.
Make sure you like and share.
Yeah. Really, man.
Hey, make sure you like and share. We got tickets to give away, man. Free tickets to give away, man. You want to meet Rick Ross? Hit me up, Ron up, ILLCHILD, somebody.
Whoever slapped me the hardest, man, you get two free tickets.
Ron, why you want a nigga to slap him? Look, this is the smartest dog people. Anthony, that dude, Johnson, Quando, Rondo, thank you. Good show, brother. ILLCHILD, thank you for coming through, bro. We appreciate you. This is the smartest dog people. Y'all have a great night.
Yesterday's price. It's not today's price.
I got messages saying, what's up with the show?
One to where you still got kids writing essays on.
472. Shout out to Chris. He came through.
Came back there. And you go, okay. And she said,
okay, he done. He did it. It's not money, baby. They don't need cash in their hands.
Right, so now with the fuck with that
regardless of the fact, you don't know
the
fucking
intentions. Teaching that, what are people, listen, I'm gonna take my time down here.
Right, I didn't understand.
When I tried to conduct,
come on,
and I'm talking.